Universal Control is finally here, people. It was first announced during WWDC 2021 when Craig Federighi awed us all when he hopped between an iMac and a MacBook and an iPad while using the peripherals on one of the machines. Basically, one computer to rule them all. But 7 months later, I began to think that this could be the next AirPower project that would never see the light of day. Before we get into all the details that I'm sure you're interested in, let's first explain what Universal Control is. In the most simplest way, Universal Control allows you to control multiple Apple devices all with a single keyboard and mouse. That includes an iMac, MacBook, and an iPad. Imagine having a MacBook and besides it your iPad, and you use just the trackpad and the keyboard of the MacBook to control both devices. Don't be confused with sharing your screen with the iPad, which is sidecar, where you basically use the iPad as a second monitor. Universal Control allows you to use both your MacBook as a MacBook and the iPad as an iPad, but share the same peripherals on both while also being able to interact between the two devices. More on that in a second. The simplest implementation and showcase of this feature would be to move over the cursor from the Mac to the iPad. The initial hint of the success of this operation is when you see a little vertical line that extends over to the other screen as if you're trying to cross to another universe. A really cool way to hint for this interaction. Once the connection is established, you are now free to move between devices as you see fit and use them as separate entities that can interact with each other. As with everything Apple, no initial setup is required and everything works seamlessly and effortlessly. Universal Control works with up to 3 devices, so if you have an iMac, a MacBook and an iPad, for example, you can just use one of the machines as your primary control device and, as I said, rule them all. And yes, gestures work on all devices accordingly. For example, using 4 finger swipes on the iPad goes back to the home screen and also swipes between the apps. This is just awesome. The few settings that people might be interested in all live under System Settings on the Mac and under Displays. This is where the iPad screen shows up too once the connection is established. What's cool here is that you can set up a continuous connection between the devices, which will allow you to always have the devices talking to each other and continue using them with Universal Control as time goes by. This feature is very important for the iPad, and it further proves that the iPad will never run macOS or emulate what the Mac does. Instead, it will further serve not only as a different standalone creative device, but also as the best companion to the Mac. With the ability to copy and paste between devices and drag and drop files, you can use a Mac and an iPad and really push the productivity boundaries. For example, you can drag and drop files between the Mac Finder and the Files app on the iPad. Or you can grab an image from the Mac and drag it over to a Pages document that you're separately compiling on the iPad. Possibilities are huge, and I plan to go into more ideas and implementations in a separate video, so subscribe and stay tuned for that. Here are a few FAQs you might have. As you'll see, the Mac knows where the iPad is and can establish the connection based on its presence. If the MacBook is on the left and the iPad is on the right, you move right to cross over to the iPad. But what happens if you move the iPad to the left of the Mac when the connection is established? Well, the connection remains on the right, but you can switch the location of the iPad screen from display settings. Of course, when the connection is re-established later, the location of the screen updates accordingly. Does it lag? No, it does not. It works so smooth and buttery that it makes you forget that you're using 2 separate devices. Can you use it if you're not connected to the same network? Yes, you can. I turned off the Wi-Fi on my iPad, which doesn't have a SIM card in it, and I'm still able to use Universal Control. Does it know where the other device is positioned? When the initial connection is established, the devices recognize their own positions. Hey, sorry for interrupting guys, but I just realized I had a question myself that I forgot to put in the video, and that is what happens when you connect the Mac to an external monitor, and how does Universal Control work? Well, it's actually very simple. Positioning is based on the relationship between the iPad and the MacBook, but rest assured that can easily be fixed and changed over to display settings. Now back to the video. What are the requirements for Universal Control? So far, the only requirement that I know of is to have all devices connected and registered with the same Apple ID. is Universal Control officially available? By the time you're watching this video, Universal Control works on Mac OS 12.3 and iPad OS 15.4, which during the recording of this video are in public betas, but rest assured will come to all users shortly. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe to the channel because why not? It's been an absolute pleasure. This is Z, over and out.